In this video, you will learn how to create simple bar plots using StatCrunch. The data set I am using is called Two Categorical Variables. This is just a toy data set that contains two columns of data. In this video, I will focus on the var 1 column that contains 10 values, the value of B in 4 rows, and the value of A in 6 rows. Let's begin by creating a bar plot with frequency on the y-axis. To do so, under the graph menu, choose bar plot with data. I'm going to select the var 1 column and click compute. The resulting bar plot indicates a frequency of 6 for the value of A and a frequency of 4 for the value of B. Now let's adjust our bar plot to show relative frequency or percent on the y-axis. To do so, under the options menu, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we built our bar plot. In this window, StatCrunch allows the user to customize their bar plot. In the box labeled Type, I'll change it to a percent. Click Compute. Now the bar plot shows the value of A as 60% and the value of B as 40%. Notice by default, StatCrunch orders the values on the x-axis in ascending order, or in this case, alphabetic order. To change that, we can go back under Options, and you'll notice a box that says Order By. It defaults to value ascending. Value descending will reverse this order. Count ascending and count descending we'll order the x-axis by the frequency of the values rather than the values themselves. For this example, I'll choose value descending. I'll click compute, and now you can see the value of B comes before the value of A on the x-axis. StatCrunch also allows the option to combine values with a small relative frequency into one other category. In this box labeled Other if percent less than, I'm going to enter 50. This will group all values less than 50% into one other category. I'll click compute, and as you can see, the B values are now labeled as other. Also, you should notice that StatCrunch has changed the order of the values on the x-axis. The other category will never appear first on the x-axis. It will always appear last. As you can see, this is really not a great idea for this data set, but it shows how StatCrunch can create this category if needed. Lastly, StatCrunch can also show the numerical value of the bar in the bar plot. Back under Options, check the box under Display that says Value Above Bar. Now click Compute. And now StatCrunch displays the numerical value above each bar.